Ya, nitaanza na kuelezea kuhusu excretory products kwa human being ambayo ni urea, lakini kama unavyojua urea inatoka kwenye ammonia. So nitaelezea the process of formation of urea. And here we had a question in the previous page which says the question was describe the fate of excess amino acid in the mammalian body. Fate, that means is like how do we dispose, tunaipeleka wapi excess amino acid kwenye human body? Au swali lingine ungeweza kuulizwa, outline the mechanism of formation and the removal of urea in mammals. Mechanism of formation and removal of urea in mammals. Au describe the fate of excess amino acid. Haya maswali mawili yote yanataka uelezee demination pamoja na ornithine cycle. Kuna tukisema ni kwamba excess amino acids in the body of mammals are firstly deaminated in the liver to form ammonia which is converted to urea for excretion. That means excess amino acid, they cannot be stored in the body. So they are firstly deaminated and then followed by conversion of ammonia from deamination to urea. The process of converting excess amino acid into ammonia is called deamination. How does this happen? Deamination is the process of removing amino group from amino acid to form ammonia. So we are removing amino group from amino acid in the presence of oxygen to form ammonia. During deamination, the amino acid is broken down or it is oxidized because the reaction involves addition of oxygen into two separate groups, the amino group, which is NH2, and the keto group. The keto group can enter the Krebs cycle and can be used as the source of energy in cell respiration. Kwa hiyo hivyo ndipo ambavyo huwa inafanywa keto group of the amino acid during deamination. But the amino group is converted to ammonia, NH3, during deamination, is converted to ammonia during deamination. So the reaction showing this process, it is 2 NH2, then carbon R, H. So R and H, this is just the summarization of the general structure of amino acid is how we studied in biochemistry. Then if we plus oxygen, you will get 2 C O. So this O comes from oxygen. The group COOH, which is carboxylic group, remains there. And then R, which is alkyl group, remains there. This NH2, it is removed. And then after removal of this, we are forming new bond here. This hydrogen will come to combine with this NH2 to form NH3, which is ammonia. The hydrogen will go to combine with this, and then oxygen from here will come and bond here with carbon. So it will be amino acid plus oxygen to form keto acid plus ammonia. That's how the reaction of deamination takes place in the liver. So ammonia produced during deamination is converted in the liver into soluble excretory product, urea. This occurs by a cyclic reaction known as ornithine cycle. Now, let's see how this ornithine cycle takes place. If we'll be asked a question to explain ornithine cycle only, ukiulizwa swala ku explain ornithine cycle peke yake, bila kuulizwa kuelezea kuanzia mwanzoni, utaanzia kuelezea hapa. At the beginning of the cycle. So, if you are asking about the ornithine cycle, first you will give introduction that the ornithine cycle, the reaction in the river, or the reaction which is occurring in the body, and more especially, you need to specify the organ in which the reaction is taking place in the river, reaction which is taking place in the river, which convert the ammonia formed from deamination to a soluble product which is urea or to a less toxic soluble product which is urea. One important thing we are doing with the deamination is to make urea less toxic, because urea, I mean, is to make ammonia less toxic. So the less toxic product of ammonia is urea. Urea is less toxic as compared to the ammonia. And because human being, we are terrestrial, and we can't excrete ammonia as itself. The reason behind why we can't excrete ammonia as itself, the reason behind that ammonia is very toxic, so its removal will require large amount of water. While being we are terrestrial, that means we have small amount of water in our bodies. If we excrete ammonia, we'll be required to consume a large amount of water, which will be difficult for us. So, kama umeulizwa kuelezea ornithine cycle, tanzia hapa. At the beginning of the cycle, ammonia from deamination and carbon dioxide from respiration combine with ornithine to form citrulline in the presence of enzyme ornithine carbon transferase. Ornithine carbon transferase. So, here we have the compound about tayari inakuwepo kwenye liver, inaitwa ornithine. Sasa huyu ornithine ana combine na carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide inatoka kwa respiration. Ornithine combine na carbon dioxide tunapata compound inaitwa citrulline. Na enzi ya mwane kata hizi reaction inaitwa ornithine carbon transferase. Kama nafahamu, enzi ya mwane kipewa jina transferase, that means anakuwa na katali the transfer of a certain group of elements or a certain group of compounds. So this is called ornithine carbon transferase because it catalyzes the transfer of carbon kutoka nje kuja kwenye ornithine to form the compound which is citrulline. It is not much important for you to know the formulas of these compounds because you will not be asked in the exam about the structure of citrulline or ornithine. But what is important for you to know is about the process, how it happens. So the first reaction is the combination of ornithine with carbon dioxide from respiration to form citrulline in the presence of enzyme ornithine carbon transferase. This process involves condensation in which a molecule of water is lost. A molecule of water is lost. Now from there, the second step of the ornithine cycle, I am saying the second step because some of people, they are liking to write it in steps, but some of people, they are joining explanation. You know, for we teachers, mwanafunzi akiambiwa explain, maybe I may explain the steps of ornithine cycle. Maraka atakio andike kwenye step. Iyo at the beginning, you step ya kwanza, ya pili, you step ya pili. Awa akiambiwa explain the reaction of ornithine cycle. Anaweza akaandika kwenye steps. Lakini mwingine anaweza kaambia explain the process of formation of urea. Simply like that. If you are told to explain the process of formation of urea, there is no much need of writing the steps. Kwa sababu mwambia to explain the process. Unaweza kashuka tu kama esi. But writing in steps, it is easier for the teachers to mark your answers. Kwa sababu wanakuwa naona. The students understand that this process takes place in steps. So mwalimu anasoma na okay, step 1, step 2, step 3. Oh, the student understand what he answers or what she answers. Lakini in case mtu anaandika tu kitu ambacho kiko general, maelezo ambayo hayana step, inakuwa very difficult kujua a context ya mwanafunzi. So the second step, citrulline then combine with another ammonia to from deamination to form arginine in the presence of enzyme arginase. This reaction also involves condensation reaction. Kwa hiyo, citrulline ambayo tumemform ana combine with another ammonia to form arginine. Na enzyme wanaitwa arginase. Hii pia ni condensation reaction ambayo involve loss of water. Then step number 3, in the presence of the enzyme argino, succinate lyase. Arginine is hydrolyzed into urea and ornithine. Kwa step ya tatu, arginine tunamuhydrolyzed, tuna add water. Kumbuka tume remove water mbili, tume add water moja. Kwenye step ya tatu. So it's hydrolyzed into urea and ornithine. The produced urea is transported through bloodstream to the kidney where it is eliminated through urine. And here below we have the diagram of the ornithine cycle as how it takes place in the liver. Now for this diagram is taken from biological science book, but also we have the diagram from understanding biology book. And this diagram, I can say that they are similar. They are similar and they are explaining the same thing. But for most of students, they understand this diagram from biological science. However, even that from understanding biology is understood because in a diagram, understanding biology is ammonia meziweka chini, is product meziweka juu. Kwa it is the same thing, just tu wamegeuza kama hivyo. Kwa hiyo diagram ikigeuzwa, haina maana process inageuka. Tukianzia hapa ornithine, inachukua carbon. Ornithine carbon join with ammonia. So ornithine in the presence of carbon from respiration join with ammonia from deamination. Then with the release of water which is condensation we form citrulline. Citrulline join with ammonia, release of water arginine. We hydrolyze arginine by addition of water forming urea and ornithine which proceed the next cycle. This is the part of urea formation. The part of urea formation. So in the next session, we'll start discussing about the structure of mammary nephron before going to discuss about urine formation. So we discuss first about the structure of mammary nephron.